Godfrey, I am so excited about this segment this morning. I'm going to give you 1 minute to reach out to someone, send them a text message, tell them to tune into Bahamas at Sunrise right now, because I've got Lisa Nichols on with me, along with Callie and Newton, and these two phenomenal women are going to be sharing their stories with us very briefly this morning and talking about how you can take your story and turn it into something more. So excited to get this conversation started. Ladies, good morning and welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise.
Good morning. Thank you for having us.
A pleasure to have you with us. Lisa, I'm going to get started with you. Certainly, we know your story, those of us like Colleen and I who want to continue to inspire people and motivate people. You have kind of been leading the way in this charge. You've gone from being a single mom on public assistance to now a millionaire entrepreneur, speaking to people around the world, just got back from Barcelona, and now you're coming to share your story here in Grand Bahama. Talk to me about what was that moment in your life that just transformed everything for you?
It was just a moment of recognizing that my life was broken.
Okay.
You know, the day that I didn't have money to put Pampers on my son.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to wrap him in a towel for 2 days.
Wow.
That was a moment when I realized this has to be rock bottom.
Okay.
I'm broke and broken. I'm on government assistance. Mm-hmm. I'm eating beanies and weenies every day. Mm-hmm. And my son is wrapped in a towel and he's 8 months old. And this future, I don't want this to be our future. And so it was a moment when I just got sick and tired of being sick and tired and knowing that I could be someone out in the future, but my future seemed to never come.
Okay.
My now was pretty ugly, but my future was bright, supposedly.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to make my future my now. And so I just began to figure out how do I feed myself something different? Because what I knew was that I only can go as far as based on what I had in my head.
Okay.
And so I think the biggest mistake we make is we try to take ourselves to the next level without learning anything new.
Okay.
And so I'm real big on mindset shift, because if you change your mind, everything else has to follow. But if you don't change your mind and you try to change your finances or change your address or change your partner,
mm-hmm.
you're going to slingshot back to the same behaviors because your mindset is the same.
Okay.
And so when I began to change my mindset, all of a sudden things begin to transform. I begin to read things differently. I begin to go to conferences where no one looked like me.
Okay.
I was the only black person, the only woman, the youngest person by 22 years, and I didn't care because I was trying to rescue Lisa.
Okay. I mean, and certainly you've done that. You've taken that moment, transformed your mindset,
mm-hmm.
and over time you've just become this global powerhouse. You've got books now. You are doing motivational speaking now. But I like the fact that you talked about and kind of mentioned that this didn't happen overnight.
Oh, no.
What was the process like? How long did the process take? Because I think a lot of us want to do it.
Yes.
We want it now.
Right. You want to Google download it.
Yeah.
You want to put it in the microwave.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Uh-huh.
It was a layered approach. So first it was mindset shift. And then I began to look at my finances differently.
Okay.
And so my mindset shift was probably, you know, I would say it was a 3-4 year investment to just understand that this is available for me.
Okay.
It's not just for those people over there
mm-hmm.
who look like that,
mm-hmm.
who's in that skin tone,
mm-hmm.
who's that age or that gender. It took 4 years, but I didn't have anyone around me who was talking like this.
Okay.
I felt like an alien. Mm-hmm. I was odd. And so now what I love is that there's a community of us finding each other based on online social media.
Mm-hmm.
This, I'm gonna age myself, but this was before online social media. You know, the social media was the telephone and the phone book.
Uh-huh.
And so now we can find each other and build a tribe. And then financial transformation,
mm-hmm.
that was longer because like our financial blueprint is embedded in us. We get it from our grandmothers and our grandfathers and we love them,
mm-hmm.
but we're living with old financial scarcity conversations, which is why I love Kayleen. Kayleen is in financial management, so she talks about wealth. And so I had to get out of living month to month to going living year to year,
mm-hmm.
then get out from living year to year to living 3 years, then from living 3 years to 5 years. My 10-year and my 15-year plan is already written out now.
Okay.
That's a whole nother language. No habla español, right? It was just a whole nother mindset. And so it wasn't overnight. I tell people, this is not, my grandmother says the best things that you love from her come out the oven, not the microwave.
Okay.
This was an oven base. But when you start,
mm-hmm.
every day you're a little bit closer. I tell people, you're going to get 5 years older anyway.
Okay.
Let's plan now for what you want to see mm-hmm. 5 years from now, and then let's reverse engineer it
mm-hmm.
and then begin to live out, make that plan there, and then just fill in the blanks to make that plan mm-hmm. happen. Without that plan, you just hoping and praying and wishing that you don't run into a wall.
I mean, my mind is blowing. So many things going through my mind right now, Colleen, about all the things that I even want to just start to do now that I'm hearing Lisa talk.
Yes.
And I'm sure that when she comes to Grand Bahama, people will feel the same way. Colleen, you and I are from Grand Bahama. We know how depressed the economy has been. We know the challenges that people have had financially and so many other ways. Why was this important for you to bring Lisa Nichols to Grand Bahama to begin to educate the community?
The reason this was so important is because it goes back to what Lisa says. Mm-hmm. It's a change in mindset. You cannot let your environment determine how you think, mm-hmm. how you act, and how you do, and what you do, mm-hmm. and what you pass on to your generations. Okay. Because if you sit in that, mm-hmm. then you will go nowhere. Okay. Nothing will manifest. And in order to have manifestation in anything, you have to start with yourself. Okay. So you can't look around in the environment. Everyone is like, but this, why did you go to Grand Bahama? Mm-hmm. Number one, I'm Grand Bahamian, mm-hmm. you know? And I want my place of birth, where mm-hmm. I live now, where I play now, where mm-hmm. I enjoy life. Mm-hmm. I want that to be a place of flourishment for everyone there.
Okay.
You know, and we have to look at that. And one of Lisa's mantras is, I am my own rescue. Mm-hmm. And we in Grand Bahama have to realize we are our own rescue.
And everywhere. Like, I love the fact that it's in Grand Bahama, but anyone gets to hop a 42-minute flight. I mean, the last time I was here was 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I travel all over the world, and everyone's always asking me to be somewhere.
Right.
You know, I have on my social media platform in total, we now have nearly a million people over 700,000 on Facebook alone.
Wow.
You know, and so I'm really clear that I can't be everywhere. So this woman moved a mountain to get me here.
Mm-hmm.
She worked for 18 months to get me here.
Yes.
It's
wow.
no easy feat and no cheap feat either. And so I would say if you're in earshot and you're ready to find out what are those first three steps, you don't need to know the first 20.
Uh-huh.
You need to know the first three. That's why your head is going. Because
mm-hmm.
the moment you ignite a fire, there's something that happens about proximity and energy.
Mm-hmm.
And when you ignite a fire, all of a sudden you can't go back to sleep on that thing.
No.
You want as many sparks as as possible around you. You don't want to be the best spark in your circle. I'm always in a circle where I'm maybe the brightest spark, and I'm in a circle where I'm the dullest spark,
because
I want someone to light me up and light me on fire. And so that's what this is about.
That's awesome. And so, Colleen, how do we get registered? I mean, when does the event happen, the date and the time, and how can we get registered? Because I know that people are going to want to come to Grand Bahama just for this.
Yes, it's easy registration, www.calinenewton.com. That's my name, calinenewton.com. And the event is October 5th and 6th in Grand Bahama, of course, and the venue is the Regency Theater.
Okay.
So if you go to the website, all information, all details, how to get tickets, any cash and go, it's very convenient.
Okay.
You can purchase your tickets or you can purchase them online at tickets.cashandgobahamas.com.
I mean, simple and easy to get connected.
Yes.
And of course, I'm hoping, Colleen, we'll get to hear your story in Grand Bahama, too.
Yes, you definitely will.
Because I know that you are phenomenal.
Powerful.
I mean, and just where she's come from.
Yes.
Of course, Lisa will be there. Ladies, I'm so excited.
Very,
I know that
yes.
the best is yet to come for both of you, because only good things happen when you come to Bahamas at sunrise. And certainly, I received that energy back from you. So thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you for having us.
You're watching Bahamas at Sunrise, where we're giving you the power to change your lives. Remember, you can go on to www.calinenewton.com for more information on how you can hear Lisa Nichols speaks. She's going to give you those first three steps, just the first three, and you're going to watch your life soar. We'll be right back after this commercial break.